What is the first thing that comes to mind when you hear the word database? The reality is that this question is not as easy as it seems. An answer like, a large file that stores loads of information, is not entirely correct and does not fully reflect the goals, tasks, and capabilities of the database. The main purpose of a database is to organize huge amounts of data, combinations of which can be retrieved quickly upon user request. At the same time, a database should be compact, well-structured, and efficient in terms of data retrieval speed and storage space. This can be achieved with various methods and techniques, some of which will be discussed in our video. So let us begin. We will be using MySQL, which is a popular, freely distributed database management system. To enforce functions and properties in a database, the constraint mechanism is used. Simply put, database constraints are the rules that define relationships between tables. The server can check and update data in tables according to these rules. All in all, the constraint mechanism helps ensure the referential integrity of the database. The main key constraints in a database are primary key, also known as a primary keyword, unique key, also called alternate key, and foreign key, that provides a link between data in two tables and guarantees referential integrity between the parent and child tables. In this video, we will focus on primary keys. You can learn more about foreign keys from another video on our channel. A primary key is one of the main constraints in a database. It uniquely identifies each record in a table and thus must be unique itself. Primary keys are created in parent tables. In fact, a primary key is a field or a set of fields that serve as a unique identifier for each individual record in a database table. A primary key must be not null. A table can only have one primary key, which, as we already mentioned, can consist of one or more fields. When a primary key consists of multiple fields, it's called a composite key. In a column defined with a primary key constraint, you cannot have two records with the same value. In other words, the primary key columns accept only unique values. Think of a database as a big bookcase full of books. All books are different, there are no identical titles, and are placed on the shelves. These books are nothing but tables with data. Each book has a name, which is unique within this bookcase. Pretty much the same as each table in the database has its unique name, which is of course unique only within a particular database, but can be used in another. Each book consists of pages. Those pages represent data or table records. So when you need to find something in a book, how do you do it? You go to the subject index to find out the page number, and then you look at the corresponding page in the book. The primary key is the page number in our example. It allows you to find, or unambiguously identify, a specific piece of information, which is a metaphor for a record in a database. As we already mentioned, a table can have only one primary key, which can consist of one or several fields. When a primary key consists of several fields, it's called composite. In MySQL, a primary key can be created using the create table statement or the alter table statement. Usually a primary key is created along with the table. You can see the syntax for this on the screen. To create a primary key in the existing table, use the alter table statement. In MySQL, it looks like this. To drop a primary key, MySQL also uses the alter table command. When deleting a primary key, you do not need to specify its name, since there can only be one primary key in a table. MySQL has a mechanism for creating a primary key using the auto-increment feature, which facilitates database development and design. Keys created in this way are called surrogate keys. A surrogate key is an auxiliary field added to the existing table, and its only purpose is to serve as a primary key. The value of this field is not based on other data in a database, but is rather generated artificially. This can be done using either AUTOINCREMENT or UUID. A typical example of such an auxiliary field is the AUTOINCREMENT counter. Each time a new record is inserted into a table, a unique value is generated automatically and added to the AUTOINCREMENT field. You can also implement a surrogate key using UUID, but this is a topic for another video. Let's now look at a couple of practical examples. To demonstrate them, we will use one of the best integrated development environments on the market, dbForge Studio for MySQL. This IDE lets you interact with databases in two ways. First, you can run SQL queries in a classic way, like you do in the command line. Second, the Studio delivers a user-friendly graphical interface, which is equally convenient for both experienced and novice developers. We will be using the SQL demo database in our examples. The database consists of several related tables featuring cinema-related data. For demonstration purposes, we will create an empty database under the name SQL. The idea is to show you how the database tables with primary keys are created. You can also find the full SQL database structure at this link. First, let's create a database. As you can see, we have already connected to the server. By the way, to learn how to establish a database connection in dbForge Studio for MySQL, watch this video. To create a new database, we right-click the Database Explorer and select New Database. Then we specify the name of the new database, configure its options, and click Apply. The database is created. As we mentioned earlier, you can create a primary key when you create a table. To demonstrate this, we will create a table using the Studio's graphical table editor. Let's create an actor table that will contain information about actors. We enter the name of the column, actor ID. Next, in the data type dropdown, we select small int. In order for this field to become the primary key, we select the corresponding checkbox. As you can see, the auto-increment and not null option get selected automatically because this column is of a numeric type. If necessary, auto-increment can be disabled. This option is only available for numeric columns. And for the final touch for this column, we select unsigned. This way, negative values cannot be inserted in our actor ID column. Let's add a few more columns to our table. These will be first name, and last update. For the first name and last name columns, we select the string data type varchar. And for the last update, we select timestamp. And we want the fields to always contain a value, so we select not null. We're almost there. To finish, just click Apply Changes, and the table will be created. If you click Script Changes, the Studio will open the table creation script in SQL Editor. There, if necessary, you can modify and execute it. Now let's get back to our graphical table editor. We click Apply Changes. As you can see, the table with the primary key has been successfully created. You can check the constraints on the Constraints tab. It shows that our actors table has the primary key constraint. And if you want to add another primary key to the table, you simply cannot do this as the option is disabled. That's because a table can only have one primary key, and there already is one. Using this menu, you can add other constraints, and if necessary, drop them as well. This is how you can create a primary key when creating a table. And now let's consider the case where you need to add a primary key to an already existing table. In our database, the country table has already been created. It contains a list of countries. But there is no primary key in it yet. The Constraints tab is empty. This means there are practically no restrictions on data entry. As an example, let's add 5 rows to the table. Monaco is repeated twice, but this is done intentionally. And now again, let's say by accident, we add the same data to the table. As you can see, the data is duplicated, and Monaco now occurs 4 times. If we wanted to create a list of countries, we have not succeeded. However, everything is not so bad and can easily be fixed. First, we delete all records from the table and add a primary key to it. For this, we select country ID as a key column and select unsigned, so that it allows only positive values. To save changes, click Apply Changes. If you click Script Changes, all those modifications that have been done in the graphical editor will be displayed as a SQL script. Now let's go back to our table and save the changes. As you can see, the primary key has been successfully created. And once again, we add the same rows to the table. As you can see, the Studio throws an error. We have a duplicate value in the country ID column. This is the work of the primary key constraint. Now let's delete the duplicate row and run the insert statement again. The rows have been added successfully. It's the primary key constraint that has not allowed any of the duplicate records to be inserted into the table. And now, imagine that when entering data into the country column, a duplicate value has been added. For example, the USA. And so now we have one country with two different IDs. In other words, we are facing a situation where there are no duplicates in the country ID column, but in the country column, one value appears twice. Unique constraints can help prevent such a situation. Unlike a primary key, there can be more than one unique constraint in the table. Thus, we need to add a unique constraint to the country column. Now, if we try to add a country that is already in the database, the server will throw an error as the unique constraint prevents duplicate values from being added to the columns. Let's sum it all up now. The primary key is one of the mechanisms to organize cross-references for database tables. Primary keys prevent data redundancy and ensure the so-called referential integrity of the database. And as we've already mentioned, primary keys are closely related to foreign keys. To demonstrate this, let's open the database diagram. As you can see, the diagram shows all the attributes, tables, as well as restrictions and relationships between tables in the database. In the given example, you can see a primary key, table constraints, a unique index, and the relationship between the city and country tables. That's it! We invite you to download a free trial of dbForge Studio for MySQL and see for yourself that working with constraints doesn't necessarily need to be painful and distressing.